speaking at the very interesting topic, that is the, you know, new directions in Indian polity and the way forward. Guru Chaturji has just said about the intolerance. And he has a related intolerance with many other things, you know. But I, as a university professor and professor of geology, and again professor of transdisciplinary subjects, because now I'm an environmental geologist, by way of in the industries in certain committees, I relate more to corporate social responsibility and enterprise social commitments. I have a little different view than what he has said, but he's right, but you know, I have some more views about that. See, young India, it is young India now. Young India means that we have 34 crore of students or young people. They are not students, they are young people in the age of 18 to 35. And this is the strength of the country. And this will increase by, you know, to almost 64% of the population in 2020. You can understand what strength we are going to get. But unfortunately, what's happening is that only the gross enrollment ratio in the universities is 24%. What does it mean? That only, sir, only 9 crore of the total people are admitted in the higher education. And out of that, 50% either fails or leaves the higher education. And even out of that, 50% gets unemployed. Or 53% is the unemployment ratio in the undergraduation, and 89% is the unemployed engineering graduates in the country. I know this has a real mark on the society. And what Atalji has said, that now the politics from corruption to intolerance, indiscipline, and you know, impatience is increasing. It is due to this cause, because 34 crore of people in the country are unemployed, they don't have work to do, and we have to find a strength to do something there. And rightly I'll say that the way forward, which you have said here, is being given by Gandhiji, or as he's been always talking about the tolerance, patience and discipline. And I tell you, especially when you talk intolerance, the intolerance of speech is very important, because intolerance of speech means anybody can speak anything, and you know that hurts. If somebody says that army is there, he helps them, but balatkar ho rahe hain, मैं तो सोच भी नहीं सकता कि क्या आर्मी के बारे में हम लोग ऐसा सोच सकते हैं. इन चीजों को किस तरह से रोका जाए, कैसे इस इंडिसिप्लिन को खत्म करा जाए, दिस रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इज फॉर अवर यूनिवर्सिटी सर. दिस इज रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फॉर द यूनिवर्सिटीज, बिकॉज वी आर द पीपल हु आर टीचिंग यंग पीपल. एंड आई थिंक हियर द रोल ऑफ टीचर कम्स, द रोल ऑफ टीचर्स टू टीच देम, to tell them what is tolerance, what is discipline, and what is, you know, what is ethical and what is unethical. And I think this is very important. Somewhere we have to take this in our curriculum. And unless we take it in our curriculum, it is not possible to change the system. After Gandhiji, the way forward was recently by Modiji. Because he said three things, and I always like those three things: the digital India, the skill India, the make in India. But there are certain things, you know, who's going to lead over that? The digital India, the skill India, the make in India. It is the young people. It is you people. It is you, the young people, who are going to lead it, lead for that. And if you don't have tolerance, if you don't have patience, if you don't have discipline, it's going to make a problem to us. And for the country. And for that, you know, I will say that let's begin with, in the digital India, please, when we talk of social media, we should be very careful of the social media, how to behave and how to take the social media forward. When we talk of skill India, we have to see how our curriculums, I'm a university professor, so that's why I say how the curriculum is made, so that we have, because now the curriculum is also fixed. You have CBCS curriculum where you have 70% and 30%, and 30% is optional, and I like always optional. And in this option, 30%, how we can put these societal things as well as the skill things, not by mere professors, but by industries, by the trainers of the country, and that has to be planned unless we know where are the jobs. And sir, for the jobs, we have to go global, because jobs total for this big amount of strength, jobs are not in India. So we have to go global, and that is where the role of developing countries research center comes up, that how we can go global about this. So as I talk, the role of teachers is very important. The globalization, thinking global as one country or one world, is very important. I remember the words of Azam Premji, and he said in 1980s, you know, the population growth is not a problem, because probably he must have understood what's going on, that population growth is not a problem provided we make them globally skilled. We make young globally skilled. So, and that is the way forward, I think Modi ji has thought, and the people now are thinking about that, how we go ahead. And next is, you know, what I talk about is that in the universities we have to make academic diversity. Academic diversity in the sense that as we are here, I'm very happy that this institution has a cross-disciplinary system and a trans-disciplinary multidisciplinary system, and they can bring together a lot of, you know, good things to the society, especially when we talk of the social society and the social aspects of the system. Another important thing is the diversity and inclusiveness. When we talk of diversity and inclusiveness, that means that how we are going to relate this social sciences or the system to the culture, to the ethnic societies, to the tribal societies. As rightly has said, you know, our job, I want to go way forward. I don't want to just stop at the point. I just want to say that let us get together by way of bringing the diversity in inclusiveness or with inclusiveness, so that together we form the one India. Thank you very much.